Hello friends, welcome to EduSkills OET Made Easy. I'm here to make you fall in love with OET, Occupational English Test. Are you ready to travel with me? Today we have a very different approach. Come along, let's jump into the session.
First one, Saddam Hussein, I am writing the short form, was dashed by government. Mansoor.
Dashed by some identity.
Mansoor from Kannur was dashed by some unidentified, hope you cannot read. Mrs. Indira Gandhi was dashed by terrorists. Simon was dashed by his neighbor. Fifth one. The sheep was dashed. The soldier was dashed in action. Could you just fill in the gaps and tell me fast? You have to use the word kill or the synonym of it. Everybody was killed. All these were killed, right? Saddam Hussein was executed by US government. Mansoor was murdered. Indira Gandhi was assassinated, you are right. And Simon was murdered. And sheep was slaughtered. And the soldier was killed. This all executed, murdered, assassinated, slaughtered, killed, all these words. All different five words. They have the same meaning, but they are used in different contexts in different ways. Known as synonyms. As you come to part B, very cool. This is going to be a very different approach. We'll be giving a particular strategy, but then you can follow any strategy. Now, what do you think is the approach for part B reading in OET? Should you read the questions first or the text first or questions and answers?
QAT.
Okay. I'll just share my screen. This is clear now what I gave you the synonyms. Just to give you an idea, go into part B and C. Synonym and paraphrasing is the most important thing that you have to be very competent with. That's what the skill. Basically, they are assessing. If someone is attending repeatedly, so attend it in the morning, please see that you don't answer, okay? If you answer, what happens, I will have the presumption the whole group knows the things.
Yes.
For part B skills, I told you this is going to be a new approach. When I give you the strategies, all the exams have different strategies and you can be very comfortable with whatever the strategies you want to follow. And the first thing I asked you, you know the basics about the whole exam. Take it for granted, right? The basic things. So the task is part B, 6 short workplace extract, workplace based policies, regulations, procedures that need to be understood and followed in medical workplace. So 6 MCQ questions with the 3 options. And you know, part B as well as C has got MCQs. And maybe in the later session, today I'll not be able to deal with it. I'll be giving you 6 strategies to answer any type of MCQs, whereby you can easily reach to the correct answer. So the skills required, general understanding of the, get the gist of the text, means the general idea. So also you should be able to understand what type of document it is. As I told you, whether it is a policy document, regulations or instructions given to medical professionals or advice given to the medical professionals or an educative text. So first you should understand what type of document is given. And second, what is it used for? You should not know for whom it is written. What is the nature of it and what is it used for? What purpose and who is the audience? That tells you the nature of the language being used. And number 3, you should understand what information is it trying to get across. What is the type of information this particular text is giving you? And as I told you, synonyms used in the questions, understand the general meaning and also be competent in paraphrasing. If you have any difficulties, I'll be going a little faster, but then any point you can stop me and ask me the things, or you can write down on your paper so that at the end we'll come to the whole clarification. So the reading format, as you said, it is QAT method. QAT method means question, answer, text. Am I audible?
Yes, Father.
Yes.
Question means you have to read the question first, then all the 3 answer options next. Scan them for the keywords, both in question and answers. Then we get into the text. But then in the third part, when you jump into part C, it's not this method. It is QTA, question first. And never ever read the 4 answer options. But after reading the question, scanning the 4 the keywords, go back to the text, then get into the answer. That is part C. But in part B, professionally, we teach QAT method. Question, answer, text. That is clear? So, most of the students have some habit of getting into YouTube videos and getting confused. And maybe they are speaking about part C and they will say QTA. Then other ones, another video, they say QAT. No, I say we teach this as the professional method. Still, you have the freedom to use your own comfortable method or strategy, whatever you want. But this is going to be easier, and I'll tell you, at certain incidents, you need not even go to the text. You can read the question and answers and find the answers even without looking at the text. If you have attended the first session, I told you how within maybe today morning, part A session, the learners could identify all the seven within 1 minute. All the seven first seven answers within a minute. We wanted to defeat the time and see, and they have done it with 58 seconds. Okay? So this is going to be the nature of our text. We'll not be looking into it in detail, but always see what is the topic, the heading. Okay, then get into the questions. 1 to 6, and you know the questions. These are MCQs with the three options, three answer options. Okay, so when you scan, this is the way you have to scan. You have to identify the important word, keyword. So here, what tests are identified in this article that determine if person has nystagmus in one or both eyes? Okay, so tests, it's plural. You should be very clear. And in one or both the eyes. Okay, second, screening for childhood obesity and vascular conditions. We'll be getting into the analysis, but just let's scan the questions. What daily activities of the child subjects in this clinical trial will be observed? If they had pre-eclampsia and their eating and exercise habits, if they have siblings. Do you know the answer? Daily activities of the child. Daily activities is the key word phrase.
B.
Among these three, which will be daily activities?
Eating
B.
And exercise.
B.
No? Yeah, definitely. Because this is a condition, disease, and this is if they have siblings, nothing to do with daily activities, siblings and daily activities. So definitely this is the answer. You need not even look into the text, I tell you. But we make it so complicated, if you go without reading the options in part B, what happens? You will be searching for this throughout the text. And this is the right answer which you told me. They are eating and exercise habits, which we'll be looking into detail later. So, thousands are actually worse for children asthma hospitalization according to new report. There is a heading. What reason is given in these articles that explains why hospitalization of children with asthma is worse in South Australia? What reason? So they are asking for a reason. Okay? They are asking for a particular reason. Lack of time. Now, what are the keywords here? Lack of time, lack of time, lack of time. Similar in all the three options. To upskill, similar in the two, three options. So only thing you have to identify, lack of time to upskill whom? Asthma sufferers, GP practice staff about asthma, hospital staff about asthma. It's about asthma, it's understood. So it is lack of time to upskill or educate. So what reason is given? This is how we scan the questions. We'll get back to that. For risks associated with the hepatitis B in pregnancy. And morning there was a question. If there are no headings and subheadings, how to identify the answer? The question answer is, go to the topic sentence. Normally, generally, the first sentence of the paragraph is the topic sentence. And there will be a keyword or key expression. For example, here, mother-to-child transmission occurs frequently either in the uterus or through plasmal leakage or this is the topic sentence. And mother-to-child transmission is the key phrase. And the whole paragraph will speak about it. So you should, we presume that you know the basic paragraph structure, the topic sentence, the supporting sentence or supporting sentences and developing sentences. Unless that is the basics, foundation of reading. We presume that you know that. For example, if there is a topic sentence, there will be a keyword or key phrase and the whole paragraph will be just explaining that particular keyword. So if you are able to identify which is the topic sentence, which are the developing sentences or which are the supporting sentences, immediately you can just swoop into the answer. See? For example, I tell you, Mahatma Gandhiji is the father of our nation. What is the keyword here in this sentence? This is a topic sentence, beginning sentence of a paragraph. Mahatma Gandhiji is the father of our nation. Tell me what is the keyword?
Father.
Yeah, father Maybe. Is the keyword. Yeah, father is the keyword. So father. The whole paragraph will speak only about the paternal qualities of Mahatma Gandhiji. You are not allowed to speak where he studied, where he did last graduation, or where he was born, None of these things are allowed to be explained in that particular paragraph. But you have to just explain why you consider or respect him as the father of the nation. You have to describe, explain with evidence only the paternal qualities of Mahatma Gandhiji. So if I say Mahatma Gandhiji is the father of the father of our nation, that is the topic sentence. The developing the supporting sentences will explain why do you say he's the father of nation. So you have to explain saying that how he has spent his whole life inside or outside, inside the prison or outside, with fighting with the British, how he spent the whole life for the nation. Then you have to give examples and illustrations saying about maybe Dandi Satyagraha and many other fights that Mahatma Gandhiji had. Then you can conclude saying that hence or therefore Indians proudly consider or respect him as the father of the nation. So it's the beauty of the paragraph. There are four official structures of a paragraph, and most of the paragraphs will start with this particular method, which I told you now: topic sentence, developing supporting sentences, then developing sentences, then concluding with the same topic sentence in other words. And if need be, later I can explain to you what are the four different paragraph structures. That is the basic of reading, foundation or foundational skill for reading. So we presume that you know that. Or the Peel method, we say point, explanation, evidence or example. Then again to the point. So we call it Peel method. Point, explanation, evidence or example. This should be the structure of it.
Be the structure.
Most children born will develop hepatitis B if their mother has hepatitis B, whatever. This is a chronic carrier of hepatitis surface antigen, has hepatitis B envelope and surface antigen. Fifth text memo, revised guideline for managing urethral catheters in adults. Okay, we don't read it. Which healthcare professional says this guideline not targeted at? The keyword is guideline not targeted to. To which group of medical professionals, health professionals? Hearing loss is text 6. Why is it important to diagnose what type of hearing loss they have? Why? Because reason should be given. Reason should be found out. And diagnose what type of hearing. Type means there are types of hearing. You'll have to find out which type of hearing. So we get into the analysis part. Are you following me?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Yes. Now, what tests are identified in this article that determine if a person has nystagmus in one or both the eyes? See, one synonym used is unilateral in the text, weakness. Here, all these three things are given. Right answer is putting water of variable temperature into the auditory canals. Cool and warm irrigations. What is irrigations? Means water. Cool and warm. Water of variable temperature. Water of variable temperature means cool and warm. That's what I told you as I gave you the first part A. You should be very thorough with the scale. You know what is scale, right? Just write down these words. Most. Then below that you can write majority. Below that many. Below that some. Below that few. F-E-W. So this is known as scale. Most means how many? Most of you. Most of the students are lazy. How many of the students are lazy?
Majority.
Many. No, it's not many. Most means it should be like somewhere near 90 plus percent.
Above 50.
Okay, majority could be anything above 50. Most means it should be extreme end. Maybe more than 80, 90. Majority means anything above 50%. If there are 100 students, 51 is majority, right? Many means how many? More than one, anything is many. 2 to 100 is many. It can be 2 or 5 or 6 or 10. You can say many students are lazy. Some students are lazy. That also says a few of them are lazy. Instead of some, you can say a few. Few of the students are lazy. What does it mean? Few of the students means no one. So instead of some, you can write a few. A few means few of the students means no students are lazy. There is little water in the well. What is the meaning?
No water.
There is no water. There is
no water.
Water. So if you add the article, it becomes some. Otherwise, it becomes negative. So this is the scale. You should be able to understand this scale. So be sure about the scale, the synonyms, the paraphrasing, comparison and contrast, nature of the text, that is whether it is opinion or fact. Definitely for part 3, part C, you require need to understand whether it is an opinion or fact. The language between fact and opinion, which means modal verbs. The basic foundation for doing your part C is understanding of modal verbs. Okay, that we will see when we get into the C part. Now, go back to the text. Say cool and warm irrigations in each ear. Unilateral. In each ear. Unilateral weakness. Enabling the physician to discriminate. Unilateral weakness. Each ear. Unilateral weakness. Cool and warm irrigations. But in the question, what is given? water of variable temperature in one or both eyes, unilateral weakness. So that's how they use synonyms. And unless you are competent in the synonyms and paraphrasing, you will have big challenge. There is no meaning in doing 100 reading practices. And definitely at the end, when you reach the exam, it's all about the luck. You'll not be competent and you'll not be confident that you'll be going through it successfully. So second one is screening for childhood obesity and vascular conditions. So when you think of obesity, what comes to your mind? How do you get obesity? Usually no physical activity, right?
Diet.
Yeah, diet. So you know, I have highlighted here. You see the question, even without getting into the text, you said this is the right answer. That's what I said. First you go to the scan the question, then go to the answer options, then only you go to the text, QAT method. Whereas for part C, it is QTA. That I'll explain to you why it is. So some of the answers, even without getting into the text, you can answer it straight away. Then you can confirm it. And worst, again, you have a scale being used here. South Australia, worst for children's asthma hospitalization according to new report. Okay. Now you see, what reason? Why? Okay. Lack of time to upskill. Not enough time. Upskill is, provide the education is the word used in the text. Asthma sufferers. Let's look back into the text. South Australia was unusual and finding out why was the magic question. And she had, there should be a full stop. She said the condition often overlooked in GP appointments, which could make management of it tricky. There is not enough time. What is the expression used in the question? Lack of time. Currently lack in the system to provide the education. What is the synonym used, paraphrasing used in the question statement?
To upskill.
That is required so that people with asthma understand the condition. People with asthma understand the condition. So the lack of time, not enough time to upskill the people with asthma. Lack of time to upskill asthma sufferers. People with asthma is asthma sufferers. So ultimately it's synonym and paraphrasing. If you haven't got that skill, definitely attend some sessions anywhere where you study how to use synonyms and how to paraphrase the statement. That's the only skill required here in part B. I am highlighting all those things. Exactly, they are texting this thing, this idea, this ability or competency of yours. Okay, text four, risks associated with hepatitis B in pregnancy. I said mother to child transmission is the key phrase. Hepatitis B envelope antigen, HBAAG, status of the mother. If a woman is both hepatitis surface antigen and HBEAG positive, 70% to 90%. Do you remember what was used there in the question statement? So 70% to 90%, just look into the question. Most.
Most.
Means 70% to 90%. I told you no scale being used. Most. 70% to 90%. Here in the question passage, you can see so many percentage mentioned. See 3%, 9%, 7%. There are so many expressions, but they are not most. Correct? And 70% to 90%? How do you read this? 70% to 90%?
Percent.
Okay. Never say percentage in your speaking. If you say 70% to 90% at any state, definitely you will score less. 70% to 90%, 80%, 20%, never percentage. 70% means it becomes doubling. Percent. The rule is this, after the digits, never use percentage. You can say high percentage, low percentage, better percentage, lower percentage, because I am not using the digits. Whenever you use the digits, never ever speak percentage, but just say percent. 70%, 80%, 90%, 95%, not percentage. It becomes doubling. So this is one of the things that really assess you. And in the speaking, if at all you happen to use that, damn sure you'll be scoring 1 point less, if not more. Okay, so most means 70% to 90%. If their mother, if a woman in the text, the expression is if a woman, here it is mother. So again, synonym. Envelope and, which means both. See, here they have said, both. If a woman is both hepatitis surface antigen and this one. Both means easily you can make out envelope and. Now there are only two things you will say, both. So if you understand the synonym, immediately you know this is the answer. Is that clear to you?
Yes, Father.
Yes. So going to the, we'll be coming back for clarifications. Any clarifications, please write down on a piece of paper. We'll get back to you. Memo, text 5, revised guideline for managing urethral catheters in adults. This guideline does not address pediatric adult patients. Limited advice for maternity and birth settings. Birth settings means again pediatric. Okay. Now let's see. See the which healthcare professionals is this guideline not targeted at? Okay, guidelines does not address. Here the paraphrasing says guideline not targeted at. So here what you have to see, for example, this pediatrician is not included anywhere here, right? First and two option, pediatrician is not included. See here, this guideline does not address pediatric catheterization. So what I want to tell you, if pediatric is not in all these two options, you need not look for other things at all. You can directly go into this option because it clearly says this does not address pediatrics. So you need not, you can, if you want to confirm later when you get back with your extra time, you can confirm other things, but not required. If it is not targeted to pediatricians, if these two options doesn't mention pediatricians, and only this option gives pediatricians, even if other things you have not confirmed, you can definitely, aged care, adult patients, again, synonym being used. Did you get the idea?
Yes.
Text 6, hearing loss. Okay, hearing loss. See, this distinction is important because sensory hearing loss is sometimes reversible. See the beauty of it. Why it is important? Because, why means reason. What type distinction and improve reversible? Sensory hearing loss may improve, which means is reversible. Okay, in the question statement, the passage, it says distinction. What type? Important because sensory hearing loss is sometimes reversible. Sometimes reversible. Here it says may improve, which means sometimes it will improve. So definitely, that's what I said, may is the modal verb, which we have to be very competent. So reversible. So here neural hearing loss does not improve. Sensory hearing loss is caused by brain tumor. It's not cause and effect language. So you should know the reason. We call it cause and effect language. This is the reason for this. The number of cars pollute the environment. Environment pollution is the result of increased number of cars. Okay, increased use of cars leads to environmental pollution. These are the cause and effect language options which they are assessing in your reading. That's it. If you want to ask me something on part B.
For the fifth text, I couldn't understand properly.
Fifth one?
Yes, Father.
See, the question is, which healthcare professionals is this guideline not targeted at? I told you, no? The nature of the text is guidelines given to the medical professionals. That's why I said you should know the nature of the text. Now they are saying this particular guideline is not targeted or not meant for a particular group of medical professionals. Who are they? So you'll have to get into the passage. It says not targeted to. This guideline does not address suprapubic catheterization, acute pediatric catheterization, or care and use of chronic or long-term catheters for adult patients. So what I told you, it clearly says, again it says, this document provides limited advice for maternity and birth settings. However, these units should refer to local procedures for further clarification. Don't depend on these guidelines. You have to refer to the local procedures for clarification. So here it says birth settings means pediatric, right?
Yes, sir.
So what I told you, even if you don't get all the three classes, as soon as you find this does not mention pediatricians or pediatrics, whereas this option mentions pediatrics, immediately you can go into that option as the correct answer. And if at all you want to reconfirm with the extra time, you can come back, get back to the question again to confirm whether these things are mentioned instead of aged care, adult patients issues, all those things. But then that is not actually required because these two things, two statements doesn't mention pediatrics. Whereas the text clearly says this guidelines does not address pediatric catheterization. Got it?
Yes, Father. Thank you, Father. Noted.
Okay. Hold on the mic closer.
No, Father. It is clear now.
Okay. Ultimately, what I want to tell you, it's not at all difficult. It's very, very easy and interesting examination. And part B is this challenging, but part C is going to be very, very easy. As I told you, don't take for granted the part A. That is the most important part. If you do well in A, definitely you can get a grade B. There's no issue at all. And I'm damn sure if you are going to get 20 in part A, and some of these group members, I know clearly they are sending me the results and I'm assessing them. Many of them, a good number of them are able to get it in 18, 19, 20 consistently in part A, some of your group members. So if you can get 20 in part A or 19 in part A, which is easy, definitely you can get 400 plus numerical score. There is no issue. And you can definitely think of it A. Okay? And most of the morning people wanted to get an A. It's not at all difficult because I tell you, this is my experience more than 2 decades. And in other institutes, and many of them are asking, what is my charge and all those things. I never charge for my services. Nowhere in my life I have charged for my classes. When I'm in an institute, that depends on the institute. But all my programs are free of cost, absolutely free of cost. But don't take it lightly. And usually I have a hobby of screening the group members within a particular period of time, whereby we'll have a separate group for the seriously interested students. And this will be a happy by group, because there are people who are already sleeping in the group. Maybe they might have gone abroad, or they have done with their exams, which we don't know. So almost we want the people to be active, because I'll be actively scheduled. Only when you are active, we will get into action. I'll be getting involved. And see that at least 10 minutes you involve yourself in this group. Send your suggestions, send your clarifications in the group. In the happiest part, which I suggested you last time, somebody asked for some material in the group, and I could find someone, Soumya Sam. She has sent fabulously, like a lot of materials within a fraction of seconds. I could see it happening in the group. That's what you have to do. What I am doing, I am trying to empower you, support you. You have to support each other. The group is an academic group. It has to go on with the discussions and involvement throughout. The more you give, I told you, no, your mistakes are my syllabus, because some of you are just started with your training. Some of you have had already some attempts, and some of you are immediately taking the exam on 24th of this month, and some of you at May 9th. So you need different types of guidelines. So maybe if the group goes well and with your interactions, we will be making different groups so that we can cater to your needs. And I always tell my learners, your mistakes are my syllabus. Okay, otherwise I don't know what you require. Okay, now send me your feedbacks with clear things. What did you learn? So that I know what is required for you. And what were the challenges, what you did not understand. Or you can even say, it was useless, I could not follow anything, you were so fast. So that I understand what, because you are from different backgrounds, your competency is entirely different skills. Okay, specifically mention, try to put it in the group, or you can mail me, you know my mail ID, or you can put me in my personal WhatsApp chat. All these things are welcome. But if you put in the present in the group, the advantage is that others will really benefit from your feedback and your things. They will also be opening up. And try to help each other, empower each other. Okay? Nobody loses anything by if everyone in this group gets a grade, isn't it? Do you lose anything?
No, Father.
No, Father.
Definitely. And I want everybody to get an A. No, I am not satisfied with B. I will not be happy with B. If at all I am training you, I want you to get an A. Okay, because I am sure, because you can ask anyone, maybe some of you are being taught by my students in some centers. I know there are various centers where my students are teaching, and a good majority of you are being taught by my students, I know, in some centers in Kerala. So what happens is, like here, where that institutes where I train, where I have the command over the policies, my policy is this: once a learner comes to me and says, I want OETB or OETA, we will assess them. After the preliminary assessment, we will tell them, you need to undergo months training or 2 months training or 3 months training, maybe full-time or part-time. Clearly, we will tell them, this is the time schedule you require for reaching this competency. And after that, they write the exam. If they don't reach that competency, if they don't get that score, we refund them the whole amount that paid to us, paid to the center. We don't give even 1 rupee with us. That is a challenge for me and for my teachers. So I'm damn sure it's possible. If you tell me that you want an A, and if you take the correct instructions and go on with the practice, strategically, with patience, definitely you will reach that. Otherwise, I can give you 1 lakh free gift. There is no issue. I am very confident with my experience. The problem is you go into 100 practice, reading practices, no use. You have to practice with analysis. Instead of 100 practices, which will give you saturation and fatigue and a dislike for the exam and material, you go through just 10 reading practices, but do the analysis and find out why I lost the score. Why I lost the score? Where did I make the mistake? What are the weak areas? For example, for B and C part, definitely unless you are competent in your synonyms as well as paraphrasing, you will never be successful. Whatever, how many practices you do, it's immaterial. Okay? Get into that criteria. Understand that.
Yes, sir.
Anything else you want to ask me? And for synonyms, when you practice, try to write down. I have shown you there's so many synonyms now, no? So many of them. The scale expression, synonyms, write down on a paper, on a notebook. Maybe make one part just for scales, one part for comparative expressions, one for synonyms and paraphrasing. Try to paraphrase, understand the paraphrasing. Don't just write the synonym word, write the whole sentence. This particular sensory deafness is reversible. Maybe reversible. Okay? Write the whole sentence and the synonym. Underline the synonyms or the way they have paraphrased. See? And don't feel bad, even if I take some students need extra care. And because now you see, if you are practicing particular text, if you can post a reading text in the group and everybody practices that particular text, what happens? That subtest, I can give you an analysis for everybody together. Otherwise, I'll have to go into almost 74 students in this group, 74 analysis of different texts. It takes a lot of time, which is impossible. I've got more than 7,000 students in my WhatsApp group. Okay? So practically sometimes impossible. So what you have to do? Try to post some material if you're practicing and discuss yourself in the group. Make it very live. I know you are all strangers, but let's come together to help each other. I never knew you because one of my students who is teaching one in one of the centers in Kerala requested me, saying that students are having a very bad time as regards OET. Could you sometimes come into the group? And that's how I got into your group. Other thing is, like, at least dedicate 10 minutes to interact in this group. I'll try to give you 3 or 4 options in a day at different timings. Choose one and try to interact so that with that interaction, I can understand what you require. So try to interact each other. And now, you know, within this 1 week, there are 17 new members in this group. I would like to request each one of you, see that you inform your friends if they want to enter into this group, let them enter immediately. Because as new members come in, they are not aware what's happening earlier, right? So communicate it to all the friends. The more the number, better it is. I'll divide them into different groups of different competency. We will train you as much as possible. Got it? And every week I'll be selecting 3 or 4 students for a 1 hour personal interaction and corrections and support, depending on your interaction in the group and your interaction with me as well as the platform. Okay? So remember, inform all possible your friends to join the group. Later we'll close the group probably. Because new members coming in, it is not their fault. No? And if they are abandoned, they will feel very bad. I don't want to do that. So, please take maybe tomorrow as the day of reaching out. Tell everybody, at least one person, tell 10 people. If they want to join, let them join it. Okay? We don't promise you everything, but depending on your interest, definitely we will give you maximum, as depending on my time available. Today, you see, I have taken 3 sessions, which is almost like 4 hours. And for this platform, today I have spent 6 hours, including my corrections and other things, feedbacks given to the students. So it may not be possible every day, at least in a week. One day I can dedicate, I believe, if you are all going on a good mood. And see that your name, now I have to change the schedule. If you don't register the name next time, the classroom, once it is pre-scheduled, only those predetermined names will be admitted to the class. Others will be, they will not even enter the room. So what happens? See that your profile gives your name, what you register here. Okay, sometimes it is said iPhone guest. That will not be admitted. You have given some other name in the list, right? And I have explained how to copy the list. You need not type everything. You just copy the list, add your, and paste it in the counter, in the chat box area. Then add your name. That's all. There are two participants raised hands. Who are they? You want to ask me something?
Yes, please, Father.
Yes, please.
Please, Father, thank you so much.
Okay,
I truly appreciate your effort and your sacrifice. Okay, I was just wondering, Father, when we are going to have part C, reading part C, part 6, please.
Yeah, definitely. I'll let you know shortly. Okay?
Okay, Father.
I will give you definitely 24 hours notice.
Okay,
probably we will try to have it tomorrow or day after tomorrow. But exact timings, okay. I'll just looking at the schedule, I'll let you know.
No problem, sir.
But I would like you, maybe now some are getting in. So most of you, I would like to have more discipline. Please, if you are not free at that time, let me know. You need not enter the classroom. I'll give you even third time repeat session. Don't worry.
Okay.
Respect the platform and love the platform. I see some of you just on the enter into the classroom and do your own business. That we can make out very easily here. Okay. Even if you mute yourself, you can understand. And from your responses, we can understand. So also your feedback tells me where you're attending my session. So the attendance will not be taken from the platform here, from the feedback. That's the attendance, the way of attendance I take. And you'll be considered on those feedbacks, and the way you take up the sessions, you'll be considered for the future sessions. Okay? We definitely will do it at the earliest C1. Okay? But then I want you to see that when you give your feedback, let me know whether you attended A as well as B part. Mention it clearly. If you have attended, I have attended A part as well as B part. Okay? And now there are many requests from the people who have joined today and yesterday. What about A part? That's what I told you. Try everybody. Inform everybody. Now itself, take 5 minutes as a time for others, charity. And inform all your friends who want to join. If you have a group of friends whom you know in this group, let me know. I'll make a separate group of yours so that you are friendly and you are more communicative and you don't feel inhibition to communicate each other. We can have group discussions, a lot of clarifications in your group. For example, there are some people from your own area, your own friends. Let me know who are they. We'll put you into one particular group. Okay?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Thank